Okay, we on the corner of 80th and Vermont, where it's called a ceasefire. Not necessarily all the way peace. We know that's going to be hard to work for, but apparently the people that came out today and the speakers are generating a message of peace. And as we do know of, with the heightened alert of what's going on in Louisiana, on the day of this peace treaty or possible ceasefire, we can honestly say July the 17th that game banging could possibly be over.
Try. see us in unity. How many of you, you ain't got to give up your organization, you ain't got to give up your religion, but I say to you, we need 10,000 fearless soldiers. How many of you would be one of the 10,000 that would stand between the games and the guns? Stand up. Stand up.
Hell yeah.
Now see, that's what the enemy, I guarantee you they're not going to show this on CNN, on CBS. That's why we need our own damn news channel. How many of you would stand in between police brutality and our community? Well, I have now, by the grace of God, deputized you to be an honorary member of the Nation of Gods.
Listen, man. Through the years, we done fought through the mental illness and the stuff that been plaguing us. And this brother is standing strong and diligent, and he's back here to do the work. But like I said from the beginning, man, I'm not no entertainer. You know, I'm a community individualist that's coming here to fight for his people. So I'd like you to introduce my boy, Manbone.
I don't really have much to say other than, man, I support a ceasefire, man. I support a passage. But us,
right,
as black people, as gang members, not as entertainment, but as gang members. This is my community, the community that I'm trying to save. And I respect everybody that's among me today. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Yo, what's up? This is that black and brown thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm Malik Spellman from the community getting down. The sister has some powerful words, and she lets you know it's not about black and brown. It's about black and brown making green. So black and brown power for black and brown people, man. And I love it for what they do. We accept it, right?
City Beans, high power. I'm right here representing my gente, my raza. Right here, showing love. It's a good thing. It's a positive movement. And we like to see more, you know, unity out in the streets with everybody.
To the people.
All power to the grassroots. All power to the Crips and Blood Nation.
All power to the
all
nation.
All power to the Nation of Islam. All power to the peace movement. All power to the
ceasefire.
Yo, looking at this in the call, celebrities and entertainers and organized efforts to try to stem something that's going on within our community, which is the black-on-black killer, black-on-black crime. This is a real serious cause. It's a real serious call. Because, you know, a lot of us, you know, dedicated our life to this whole process. I mean, live. You remember Tony Bogart, out of here, of course, Red Rooster, Big Spike, Big Blue. Many of the brothers in the Nixon Gardens who dedicated their life. Brother Kalbowski somewhere in Las Vegas, crippled, paralyzed, took a bullet, saving lives. 1992, the men of Watts stood up. The men of Watts, along with Brother Imam Mujahid, along with the support of Mr. Jim Brown, and a mighty call by the Nation of Minister Louis Farrakhan, created a movement in the late 80s that culminated into the 1992 gang truce in Watts. Many of us were successful in creating grassroots organizations that represent the grassroots people. Hands Across Watts, infamous Bob Tookie and the great Tony Bogart. Hands Across Watts, Malik Spellman, Tosti. We created an organization that represents the grassroots communities because, you know, in looking at deals and representation when it comes to resources, a lot of times, a lot of us dedicate our lives and our struggles and sacrifice our children not being good fathers, trying to provide for others, for a change.
So far the peace treaty has been signed, hasn't been July 17 gang banging is over. So that's my official report. Not only coming from me, but brothers and sisters in the community, military Crips and members. July 17 marks the signing of the peace treaty. The gang banging is officially over. So you've seen it live here on a million hits. Every organization, every from Blood to Crips, July 17th, gang banging is officially over.
The treaty being signed out front. Big boy, can you come sign a peace treaty? All of the gang, street organizations. Sister Carolyn, could you make sure to get signed a peace treaty outside? No one leaves without signing it. Everybody signs it.